5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. It would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice in its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister. The look it was giving me.
Sir, what were you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better...
Sir?
Zia!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you tonight. I have two guests coming up. My first guest is a professional bass fisherman who had a very interesting encounter while he was out fishing, kind of a very aggressive encounter. I've heard a lot of Native Americans share this type of encounter. I'm really happy to invite Ronnie to the show. And then my second guest, Gary, will be sharing his own personal encounters and also talk about an encounter that happened to his wife recently that really terrified her. She got kind of herded into an area. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. Let's jump into it tonight. I want to welcome Ronnie to the show. Ronnie, thanks for coming on, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
As you and I were talking the other night, you know, you didn't really buy into the Bigfoot thing. And I like that about your story. And I like that about, you know, you as being an outdoorsman. And having this experience. But if you would, for the audience, just kind of start from the beginning. Tell them what you were out doing, and then if you would, just kind of walk them into the encounter.
Okay, I will. I live in the state of South Carolina. And like I was telling Wes the other night on the phone call, the conversation we had, you just don't think of Bigfoots or Sasquatches in South Carolina or in the Southeastern. Well, I don't. I'm not saying I didn't believe in it. I just had no interest. Yes, I've seen the Patterson and Gimlin film. If you have walked on this earth, I'm pretty sure most people have seen that film. I'm pretty sure they have. And I think a lot of people have seen in the news and the, you know, Animal Planet and other things that's going on out there of all the shows that's about Bigfoot and Sasquatch. So more or less, if you have not lived on planet Earth, then you probably don't know about the topic of Sasquatch or Bigfoot. But, you know, in that sense, that was about as far as I took it. I knew about it. I'm not saying I didn't believe it. I'm one of them type of people. You got to show it to me, put it in my hand. My parents or my dad, you know, we were Southern gentlemen, and we grew up like on a farm. And my dad always told me, you know, son, believe half of what you see and nothing of what you hear. So I kind of grew up in that lifestyle, not believing, you know, anything anybody tells me. But if somebody says, hey, I seen a Bigfoot or a Chupacabra or whatever they might have seen or ghost, well, okay, I'm glad you seen it. I'm not going to call you a liar, but come on. To me, it's got to happen to me, more or less.
No, I understand that.
All right, so back, what happened was, I fish bass tournaments. I'm a very avid bass fisherman. I love it. I live for it. And what happens on bass fishing tournaments or bass fishing guys, we fish the lakes all over the country, more or less. And but in a geographic area, if I'm going to fish a new lake, I'm going to practice that lake for 2 or 3 days or maybe a couple weeks. Well, this particular lake is Clark Hill Lake, right above the Augusta, Georgia. And Augusta, like I said, Augusta, Georgia is a city, but right above or the outside of Augusta, Georgia, I mean, there's hardly nothing there. Just kind of picture everything like this. South of Augusta, on right across the Georgia line, and it's right on the Georgia-South Carolina border, the Savannah River splits the states, okay? Right below the Augusta, Georgia area, there's a place called Savannah Riverside. It's a nuclear facility. It's 300 to 400 square miles of nothing but forest and woods and a couple little plants that's scattered here and there in the middle. All right, go a step further north of Augusta, between Savannah, on the Savannah River, between Augusta all the way up till you get up into South Carolina, up around Anderson and Spartanburg. Up there, you're talking another 800, 900 square miles of nothing but spatted houses here and there, but no towns. If it is a town, it's very small. So you're looking at hardly no area up there for a lot of growth. But in my mind, seeing a Bigfoot or a Sasquatch, it just wasn't a part of me. And I'm going to go back to my how it happened. That morning, right before daybreak, I launched a boat in Clark Hill Lake, and I'm running up the river. And then just picture this again. I'm running up the Savannah River, which is also, you know, Clark Hill Lake. So I'm going up the Savannah River or Clark Hill, heading north. And I'm running 70, 75 miles an hour before daybreak, and I'm heading up that river. All right. Now, once you get to a bridge, is what we call no wake zone. You have to slow down and go under the bridge. All right. So I finally reached 378 Bridge, which crosses the Clark Hill Lake from South Carolina to Georgia, or Georgia's from South Carolina. It runs across the whole lake. All right, I'm back to no wake zone. I slow down, and I'm going under the bridge. And then after you pass, and the reason I'm telling you about the bridge is because after you pass that 378 bridge, on really both sides of the lake, you hardly see nothing. Maybe the first quarter of a mile on the left-hand side, you'll see a little bit on the Georgia side. When you first pass that bridge, but on the South Carolina side, there is nothing but woods. As a matter of fact, from there all the way to Lake B. Russell Lake, is a dam. All the way to that dam, you don't see the first house on the right, on the lake. Now, and I know that's hard to a lot of people understand. And on the Savannah River, you have Lake Hartwell, which is the first lake at the top of South Carolina in Georgia. Then you got Lake B. Russell, which is the newer lake. And then you got Clark Hill, which is a little lake at the bottom near Augusta, Georgia. That's all on the Savannah River. That all splits South Carolina and Georgia. Well, them three lakes back-to-back each other by their dams. All right? Now, from, like I said, the 378 Bridge all the way to where I'm going, there is no houses. Now, on the South Carolina side, this is called game management land. And this all happened around April. Hunting season's not in. On game management land on the South Carolina, you shouldn't even be in the woods, period. The game warden shouldn't catch you in the woods on game management land, not in hunting season. All right? So it's still dark. It's about 5:30 right now, and I'm just past the 378 Bridge, and I'm heading to a fishing spot with my fishing partner. He do not want to give his name. Matter of fact, he don't even want to talk about it. He don't even want to express. He don't even want to talk about it to me. To this day, he don't even talk about it. So me and him head on up, and I'm traveling. I don't know how far I go, but a pretty long ways. Think about this. I'm running 70 miles an hour past the 378 Bridge, and I'm probably running 20 minutes. So that tells you I'm pretty far up in there. All right? Now, remember, I hadn't passed the house, and all game management land. And another thing, this game management land on the South Carolina side is almost 400 square miles. You're talking a lot of land that's nothing there but.